Hello, praise the Lord. All glory be to Jesus. Nice to meet you once again back for this wonderful, beautiful healing service. This healing service, we have added the word of God. All glory and praise to the Lord. मेरे प्यारे भाई और बहनों, हम आपका स्वागत करते हैं इस हीलिंग सर्विस में. हम विश्वास करते हैं ये हीलिंग सर्विस में प्रभु का वचन आपको सुनने मिलेगा. प्रभु का कार्य आपके जीवन में जो होने वाला है उसे पूरी तरह से संपूर्ण होने के लिए प्रभु का शब्द का वचन किया है और आप ये शब्द प्रभु का सुन सकते हैं. और ये जो थोड़ा लंबा है हीलिंग सर्विस, दिस हीलिंग सर्विस इज लिटिल बिट लॉन्गर, बट आई विल बिलीव दैट यू आर गोइंग टू एंजॉय एंड ऑल्सो यू आर गोइंग टू शेयर विद योर ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स. एनॉइंटेड वर्ड ऑफ गॉड, प्रभु का शब्द जो ब्रदर यूफी और ब्रदर लॉरेंस ने शेयर किया है, तो आप सुन पाएंगे उस वर्ड ऑफ गॉड को. और ये वर्ड ऑफ गॉड आप सभी जन अपने जीवन में इस्तेमाल करेंगे. बहुत ही ताकतवर प्रभु का शब्द इस हीलिंग सर्विस में प्रभु ने हमें बताया है. हम आपका स्वागत करते हैं. आइए हम शुरुआत करें. इन द नेम ऑफ द फादर एंड ऑफ द सन एंड ऑफ द होली स्पिरिट, आमेन. आवर फादर Who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptations, but deliver us from all evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. All glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Amen. And amen. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Let us say together, for the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. As we always begin with the song of Mother Mary, we have taken this song. जैसा हम हमेशा माता मरियम को नमन करके इस प्रेजेंट इस हीलिंग सर्विस को हम चालू करेंगे. हमारे आश्रम में भी नाइट विजिल हम माता मरियम से ही चालू करते हैं, रोजरी, और उसके बाद उनको गाना गाकर उनको आदर देकर हम हमारा नाइट विजिल शुरू करते हैं. इसी तरह से हीलिंग सर्विस भी माता मरियम को हम नमन करके उनको शुक्रिया बोल के ये हीलिंग सर्विस चालू करेंगे. उनसे प्रार्थना करेंगे, ये माता मरियम हमारे लिए प्रार्थना करो. आमेन, आमेन. भाव माए यो माए घे आम का तुझा गोपाल माए यो माए घे आम का तुझा गोपान. बहुत पुराना कोंकणी गोवंश गाना है माता मरियम के लिए. हमने कोशिश किया गाने का. अगर मेरी तरफ से कोई भूल हुई है ये गाने में, थोड़ा अलग अलग वर्षन है, हमें माफ करना. फिर भी हम गाएंगे क्योंकि सबसे बड़ा हमारा दिल से जो गाते हैं वो प्रभु तक पहुंचना चाहिए. प्रेज द लॉर्ड. माता मरियम खुश होती है आप दिल से जब गाते हैं. ट्यून, उसका बीट वो जरूरी नहीं है. व्हाट गॉड वांट्स इज योर हार्ट, अपना दिल. सो ये थोड़ा फास्ट वर्षन है, थोड़ा हम गाएंगे और माता मरियम को आदर करेंगे. बोलले रानी तू सर्गा संसाराचे सदा सामचा मोगन लासले
सुरसुरे दाबोयाम चकाजचे उंडी पोस्कराम चे विघ्ना मिटमरे तातुंशी कोय सर्गीचे पावडी पाव माये यो माये की आमका तुझा गोपा पाव माए यो माए के आमका तुझा गोपान पाव माए यो माए के आमका तुझा गोपान।
अपना आंखों को बंद कर माता मरियम से विनती कीजिए। Close your eyes and pray for the intercession of Mother Mary. May the Mother Mary intercede for you and me. हमारे लिए प्रार्थना करें माता मरियम। हे माता मरियम, हमारे लिए विनती करना सभी के लिए। प्रभु यीशु की के रास्ते में चलाने को और आगे बढ़ाने को हमें मदद करना।
आओ माए यो माए के आमका तुजास गोपान पाव माए यो माए के
Praise you, Jesus. Love you, Jesus. आइए पवित्र साक्रमेंट का हम नमन करेंगे। पवित्र साक्रमेंट की आदर करेंगे, महिमा गाएंगे, स्तुति गाएंगे। मेरे प्यारे भाई और बहनों, यीशु यहां पर है, हमारे सामने उपस्थित है। रोटी नहीं बल्कि स्वयं अपना जी जान लेकर, अपना जीवन लेकर यहां पर हमारे बीच में है। उस सैक्रमेंट के द्वारा, सैक्रमेंट की आराधना करेंगे। अपना सर को थोड़े समय तक झुकाकर हम प्रार्थना करेंगे। हे प्रभु, हमें क्षमा करना जो भी पाप हमने अपने जीवन में किया है। लॉर्ड हैव मर्सी ऑन अस। हम अपने आप को इस हीलिंग सर्विस में सौंप देते हैं। वी सरेंडर आवरसेल्व्स लॉर्ड इन दिस हीलिंग सर्विस इन योर हैंड। लेट मी अटेंड दिस हीलिंग सर्विस एंड कंप्लीट इट, एंड एज आई फिनिश दिस हीलिंग सर्विस लॉर्ड, यू आर गोइंग टू डू समथिंग इन माय लाइफ. जैसा मैं हीलिंग सर्विस खत्म करूंगा, ए प्रभु मुझे मालूम है आप कुछ नया मेरे जीवन में करने वाले हैं. हम आदत करते हैं, हम आपकी महिमा गाते हैं. हालेलुया, 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 हालेलुया. मेरे प्यारे भाई और बहनों, जब मैं आश्रम की तरफ अकेला आराधना का थोड़ा रिकॉर्डिंग के लिए जा रहा था, बाइक में अकेला था, तब मैंने महसूस किया लोग सब लोग डरे हुए हैं एक कोरोना का बीमारी से. जो कोरोना, जो COVID-19 हम बात कहते हैं, उससे सब डरे हुए हैं. और मैं जब यीशु से बात करने लगा, यीशु से बातचीत करने लगा मेरा बाइक में, क्योंकि मेरा घर से आश्रम तक जाने के लिए कम से कम आधा 35-40 मिनट का रास्ता है, तो बाइक में मैं चला रहा था और प्रभु यीशु से मैं बातें कर रहा था. आई वॉज टॉकिंग टू जीसस. तभी एक गाना थोड़ा सा शब्द में गाऊंगा, प्रभु ने मेरा दिल में डाला, मेरा मन में डाला, मैं गाऊंगा. जरूर ये गाना आपको छुए, आपका जीवन बदले. जहां पर प्रभु कहते हैं हम सुनेंगे. थैंक यू लॉर्ड, प्रेज यू लॉर्ड, लव यू लॉर्ड. तेरे पास जब यीशु है, डरना क्यों मेरे दोस्त, तेरे पक्ष में यीशु है. चिंता क्यों मेरे दोस्त. ब्यूटीफुल. मैं आपको कहता हूं, मैं जब ये गाना गा रहा था और ये शब्द मेरा मुंह में आ रहा था और मैं गा रहा था और रास्ते में मैं रो रहा था, यीशु मुझे कहता है, तेरे पास जब यीशु है, डरना क्यों मेरे दो, तेरे पक्ष में जब यीशु है, चिंता क्यों मेरे दोस्त. बीमारी कुछ कर ना सकेगा, डरना ना हो तुम, अरस्तान में फैले भी तो ना आएगा तेरे पास. बीमारी कुछ ना कर सकेगा, डरना ना हो तुम, अरस्तान में फैला भी तो ना आएगा तेरे पास. Praise the Lord. There is anointing in this song. यीशु कहता है, मुझे कहता है, मेरे रास्ते में प्रभु ने ये गाना मुझे दिया, रास्ते में कहता है कि बीमारी तेरे पास आएगा नहीं, तू डर नहीं, डरना नहीं. अगर ये बीमारी आस्थान पे भी रहेगा, सब जगह पे रहेगा, लेकिन तेरे पास नहीं आएगा, क्योंकि तेरे पास यीशु है. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. हम साथ में गाएंगे ये शब्द, हम आपको डालेंगे, आप साथ में गाएंगे. There is anointing in this song. Sure, yeah, 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 yeah. Thank you, Lord. We praise you. तेरे पास जब यीशु है, डरना क्यों मेरे दोस्त, तेरे पक्ष में जब यीशु है, चिंता क्यों मेरे दोस्त. गाएंगे, तेरे पास जब यीशु है, डरना क्यों मेरे
पक्ष में जब यीशु है चिंता क्यों मेरे दो बीमारी कुछ ना कर सकेगा डरना ना ओ तुम हर स्थान में फैला भी तो ना आएगा तेरे पास बीमारी कुछ ना कर सकेगा डरना ना हो तुम हर स्थान में फैला भी तो ना आएगा तेरे
यीशु जब मेरे अंदर है कोई बीमारी आपको छू नहीं पाएगा। प्रेज द लॉर्ड। डरना नहीं तुम क्योंकि यीशु तुम्हारे पास साथ है, तेरे साथ है। जैसा यीशु हमारे साथ रहता है वो हमेशा के लिए हमारे साथ रहेगा। डरना ना तुम, प्रभु कहता है बीमारी कुछ ना कर सकेगा डरना ना हो हर स्थान में फैला भी तो ना आएगा तेरे पास। Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, as you are worshiping the Lord in the sacrament here, there is anointing is flowing right in the beginning of this session. शुरुआत में भी प्रभु ने आपको आशीष दिया है। इस गाने के द्वारा प्रभु ने आपको छुआ है। हम विश्वास करते हैं प्रभु ने आपको छुआ है, इसीलिए अपना दोनों हाथों को ऊपर उठाकर प्रभु को धन्यवाद दीजिए। प्रभु को धन्यवाद दीजिए। अपना सामर्थ्य और शक्ति अपने भाई बहन के ऊपर उंडेल दो प्रभु, डाल दो प्रभु, सबको शांति दे दो प्रभु, सबको इस हीलिंग सर्विस में अपना आशीष दे दो प्रभु। We pray Lord, pour out your power and spirit upon every brothers and sisters who are joining this healing service. Let their life be changed, let their life be transformed, O Lord. Oh, rakia, ra, 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 ra. Ah, hallelujah. Yeah. is healing you. He is blessing you. There is no one like Jesus. I can see the awesome power of Jesus in me and also in you. प्रभु का शक्ति और सामर्थ्य मेरे अंदर भी है और आपके अंदर भी मैं देख सकता हूं। बहुत सारे आंखों से आपका आंसू निकल रहे हैं। प्रभु ने आपका दुख दूर किया है। The Lord has wiped away every tear। आइए अब प्रार्थना करेंगे। हम प्रार्थना करेंगे, प्रभु से प्रार्थना करेंगे। जो भी शब्द आपके मुंह में आता है इस सैक्रमेंट के सामने जोर जोर से बोलकर स्तुति कीजिए। हालेलुया 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 हालेलुया। मेरे प्यारे भाई और बहनों, हम कहना चाहते हैं इधर कोई प्री प्लान नहीं है, कोई प्री प्लान का सेशन नहीं किया है। जैसा पवित्र आत्मा में कमरे में बंद हूं, तैयारी नहीं है, पवित्र आत्मा जैसे हमें लीड करता है उसी पवित्र आत्मा के द्वारा हम आपसे बात करते हैं। और वो पवित्र आत्मा यहाँ पर है, जिंदा है। जेनेसिस के बुक में लिखा है पवित्र आत्मा इस धरती पर मंडरा रहा था। द होली स्पिरिट वॉज हावरिंग ओवर द अर्थ इवन इन द Among every prophets, the Holy Spirit was working. और एक प्रवादी में भी पवित्र आत्मा काम करता था। प्रभु यीशु जब आए तब प्रभु यीशु ने स्वर्ग जाने से पहले उस आत्मा को यहाँ पर छोड़ा है, हमारे लिए छोड़ा है, हमारे लिए छोड़ा है। उस आत्मा का हम आराधना करेंगे और प्रभु से जोर जोर से विनती करके प्रार्थना करेंगे, हे प्रभु हम पर दया करो। जब हम गाना गाते वक्त आप शामिल हो जाइए और प्रभु की स्तुति कीजिए, पवित्र आत्मा के लिए प्रार्थना कीजिए और पवित्र आत्मा हमें अपना शक्ति से भर देगा, अपना सामर्थ्य से भर देगा। पवित्र आत्मा हमें शांति देगा, वरदान देगा, हमें संभालेगा, हमारा सब कुछ वो पवित्र आत्मा है। थैंक यू लॉर्ड, प्रेज यू लॉर्ड, हालेलुया। से भर दे मुझे पवित्र आत्मा, से भर दे मुझे आत्मा, से भर दे मुझे पवित्र आत्मा, से भर दे मुझे। सब में गाएंगे पवित्र आत्मा के लिए। आत्मा से भर दे मुझे, गाएंगे आत्मा से भर दे मुझे, पवित्र आत्मा से भर दे मुझे। जहां मैं भी जाऊं गीत तेरे गाऊं, जहां मैं भी जाऊं गीत तेरे गाऊं, ऐसा यीशु कर दे मुझे, आत्मा से भर दे मुझे, आत्मा से भर दे मुझे, पवित्र आत्मा से भर दे मुझे, आत्मा से भर दे मुझे, पवित्र आत्मा से भर दे मुझे। oh! पवित्र आत्मा को बुलाइए।
जी मेरा रोशन है चेहरा तेरा, तू ही मोना जी मेरा रोशन है चेहरा तेरा, दे दे नई जिंदगी सब कुछ बदल दे मेरा, दे दे नई जिंदगी सब कुछ बदल दे मेरा, जहां मैं भी जाऊं गीत तेरे गाऊं, जहां मैं भी जाऊं गीत तेरे गाऊं, ऐसा यीशु कर दे मुझे, आत्मा से भर दे मुझे, आत्मा से भर दे मुझे, पवित्र आत्मा से भर दे मुझे, आत्मा से भर दे मुझे, पवित्र आत्मा से भर दे मुझे।
आराधना कीजिए,
देता है तू जिंदगी, देता है तू मखलसी, देता है तू जिंदगी, देता है तू मखलसी, सब कुछ तेरे पास है, देता है तू हर खुशी, सब कुछ तेरे पास है, तू हर खुशी, जहां मैं भी जाऊं गीत तेरे गाऊं, जहां मैं भी जाऊं गीत तेरे गाऊं, ऐसा यीशु कर दे मुझे, आत्मा से भर दे मुझे, पवित्र आत्मा से भर दे मुझे,
सब में गाइए,
आत्मा से भर दे मुझे, पवित्र आत्मा से भर दे मुझे,
हालेलुया।
चला मैं उस मुझे, आत्मा से भर दे मुझे, आत्मा से भर दे मुझे, पवित्र आत्मा से भर दे मुझे, सब में आत्मा से भर दे मुझे, पवित्र आत्मा से भर दे मुझे, से भर दे मुझे,
ask for the spirit to come,
आत्मा से भर दे मुझे, पवित्र आत्मा से भर दे मुझे, आत्मा से भर दे मुझे, पवित्र आत्मा से भर दे मुझे, दे मुझे,
yes Lord, you fill us with your power and grace,
पवित्र आत्मा से भर दे मुझे,
Jesus, we cry to you, pour out your power upon us, Lord,
आत्मा से भर दे मुझे, पवित्र आत्मा से भर दे मुझे, पवित्र आत्मा से भर दे मुझे,
continuously praise God, continuously praise God, प्रभु की स्तुति करो, प्रभु यहाँ पर उपस्थित है, इस पवित्र sacrament पे उपस्थित है, Jesus is there in the blessed sacrament, go to Jesus, cry to Jesus and cry out to the Lord and say, Jesus have mercy upon us, Lord Jesus have mercy and compassion upon us, pray to the Lord, pray to Mother Mary, pray to her, go to her,
Hallelujah.
गाना रहेगा, उसके बाद और एक वचन रहेगा और अंत में हीलिंग प्रेयर सभी के लिए रहेगा। तो आइए जुड़ जाइए प्रभु का वचन सुनने के लिए, उसका ताकत से बढ़ने के लिए। बाइबल अपने पास रख दीजिए, बाइबल खोल के पढ़ाई करने के लिए कोशिश कीजिए, क्योंकि हमने डिस्प्ले किया है कौन सा वर्ड आप पढ़ने वाले हैं, वो भी है। आप जरूर इस प्रभु का वचन से भर जाए। You are going to listen the word of God now from Brother Yuffie, and then we will have one song, and after that song we will have one more word of God by Brother Lawrence, and then finally we have the healing service. My dear brothers and sisters, do not break this chain. This is a connection of the Holy Spirit, where the Holy Spirit is working. So we will listen to the word of God now. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. It's a pleasure to be back in front of you, that you are there now watching and already set to hear the word of God. Let us pray for a moment as we surrender our life, this moment this hour, and whatever we have been doing all throughout the day that has been lodged into our mind, our heart, let us at this moment still ourselves and be in the presence of God. God loves one who steals himself and is ready with an open heart, with a mind, the spirit is ready to listen to his voice calling. Dear sisters and brothers in Christ Jesus, let us at this moment acknowledge that we are nothing in the presence of God. We are just what he has made us to be, sons and daughters. He has given us his life. He's already given us his unconditional love that is holding us together. And today, at this hour, as we have prepared ourselves and we have come into his presence, let us ponder for a moment. Am I ready? Am I really ready to receive his word in my spirit, in my heart? Let us thank the Lord that this moment he is speaking to us, and tell him deep down in your spirit, Lord, I'm ready to listen to your voice. Let us think for a moment what has been happening all around our entire day, what has happened today since morning. Let us think, what was the main thought that has already been plaguing you all these months that we are under this pandemic, this lockdown? Everybody is talking about COVID-19, everybody is praying, everybody fasting, yeah, and we are not really thinking in which direction we are moving at this moment. But we are doing those things, yes, and it is good. The whole universe is talking one language, COVID-19. Every nation, every country, every city, every village, town, homes, any language you take, all of them are just speaking about COVID-19. Let us look down deep into our hearts. Where was this COVID-19? It started, everybody knows, run at the end of December, and it continued. But it is only COVID-19 that was there to disturb us. Now, what about COVID-18? What about COVID-17? What about the things we hid ourselves, lived ourselves with all these things we are not supposed to do, let go those things, but yet we have kept ourselves busy, ignoring the fact that our hearts, our spirit are not really in line and sync with what the Lord is wanting us to live. And this is what today we are going to learn, we are going to speak, we are going to meditate on the word of God. Lockdown after lockdown, restrictions are there, containments are there. Certain things we have to do, certain things we don't have to do. Everywhere, everyone is well dedicated in these matters of knowing what COVID-19 is all about. The word of mouth, media, TV, the way we communicate with each other, the topics that keep on cropping up again and again, and then we dwell on those. But in all this, how COVID-19 has grown, how COVID-19 has spread, how it has affected you in your heart, in your spirit. Before I said in your imagination, in your heart, what COVID-19 means to you. Let's see what Isaiah says in 26 and verse 9. Let us open to Isaiah chapter 26 and verse 9. If you have your Bibles, please open. With my soul, I have desired you in the night. Yes, by my spirit within me, I will seek you early. For when your judgments are in the earth, the inhabitants of the world will learn righteousness. Think for a moment what the word of God is actually telling us in this particular scripture. With my soul I have desired you in the night. So during this pandemic, what you have desired? You have desired that, Lord, as I go to sleep, I go to bed, I don't want nothing to disturb me, nothing to affect me. COVID is giving me sleepless nights. But here the word of God says, with my soul I have desired you in the night. So what has been your desire all these 5 months of lockdown, 5 months that you have been inside? What has the night given you? Sleepless nights, or you have the desire to be in the presence of God, to think about Him, to dwell on Him? Because the more you dwell on the Word of God, the more you dwell on what the Lord is actually telling you to do, the more He speaks to your spirit, that much what you gain is the peace within. Because He's a peacemaker. In every situation, you see God, when He entered even the closed room, He gave them the peace. The peace only a God can give, and that also is so precious for us at this hour, this moment. Then He says, yes, my spirit within me, I will seek you early. What with what strength, what joy have you got up in the morning? How have you given yourself to the Lord? Did you receive Him? Did you say, Lord, here I am in this morning, my spirit yearns for you. This moment I am there with you. Lord, I want to begin my day with you. But it is always at the back of mind what has been troubling us. We go to sleep with what we have been thinking about, the troubles that are there, the things which are not there. We bring them into our bedroom, we bring them and sleep with them under a pillow, and with the same sign when we get up in the morning, with a sigh in our heart, we get up with the same thing, and then the day goes on by. Are we now seeking the Lord by the Spirit within us? This is important for us to understand. Are we seeking the Lord? Well, when your judgments are in this earth, He said the inhabitants of the earth will learn righteousness. So for us to live this righteous life, we have to understand what Jesus Christ has done and accept it within our spirit, within our heart, and apply it to our day-to-day life, what exactly the Word of God, the Bible, which is the mirror, which is a reflection of what God is showing to us. And this is exactly what is important for us to understand. Let us think for a moment, what, how and what, in what manner we are searching the Lord within our spirit. Are we doing it with a sincere heart, or we have a wrong motive? Are we thinking something which is beyond the capacity of a human mind to grasp, and then get confused in the middle of the day, and then we just dwindle into what is actually not showing us any further fire inside that is building within us. We want to leave those things, but yet our body, our mind, the things that make us so fearful, the doubts that come within us, we are always seeking and trusting the Lord, but within our own self, we know things have not worked out the way we are actually normally want to think. Let us see now what and how this word brings about the inner man at the forefront. Many are seeking the Lord, many are fasting, many are praying that this pandemic will somehow go away, which has flooded our lives, which has flooded this entire human being. We are praying, and it's a good thing, it's a good thing that we have to follow this type of steps. We have to put ourselves into this particular time and period where the entire world has come together. We have to seek the Lord, the unity which is there. For a moment, let us think about our families. Who am I in this family? What is the value of my family? What am I doing for my family? What family meant to me? Is this family precious? Many a time people, when we speak about the family, this pandemic has actually brought about a radical change within the family. God is looking into your heart. God is looking into your spirit. Because God is a spirit being. You too are a spirit being. And whenever you want to connect with the Lord, it has to be in the spirit. And this is how we get connected by the spirit. And what is in the heart of the Lord? The spirit brings the very thing into our spirit. And that word, that inspiration, that wisdom, that revelation speaks inside of you, and it makes a total radical change in the outlook of how you want to see the Lord, what He is telling you. So in the family, during this pandemic, during these 5 months, many families have come together, many families have passed up. Many families have overlooked all the wrongdoings, what is happening around. Many families have come together to pray. Those who have never lifted the Bible, never opened the page of the Bible, they are all now together sitting, praying, reading the Word of God, understanding, sharing, and it's with inner joy. They express, they say, "Brother, we have received something new, which never happened in our life before. We are caught up with all our activities, our job, and each one is to be busy doing their own duties, their own way of living their life. But now, praise God, because of this COVID-19 and this pandemic, we are all locked down inside, in our own homes." That's why He said, "I will make my dwelling in that heart which is contrite and humble. I will not despise such heart. I will not despise such family." Are you that type of family? Are you a that type of family? Is your family now together praying? But sadly to say, there are many other families. They call up. They start complaining about their spouses. They say wrong things. They come up with something which was buried many years back. They dig up that grave. They pull out the very bad thoughts which is all embedded right inside in their subconscious mind. They display their anger, they display their hatred, they speak wrong words, they bring about all the negative thoughts so that they throw each other down. And this type of things which are happening in their family, there is because of the stress, that it is because of a lack of finances now, there is no security of job, people do not know how to sacrifice themselves to accommodate their own near and dear ones. The spouses, they fight against each other. The husband wants the wife to continue working. The wife wants the husband to help in the kitchen, to do some type of work and helping hand. And each one is expecting someone to chip in and do something over there. But because of the habits that we've been having all these years, it is difficult to break this pattern. But let us understand now. Let us invite Jesus at this time. Many of you all have experienced the closeness of Jesus. You have experienced the Spirit speaking to you in your spirit. It is the voice that tugging into your hearts and telling you in the direction that you should go. The flow has to be within your heart. And when you open the door of your heart, when the Lord speaks, when the Lord comes and says, you are slowly approaching the God who loves you. You are at the well beside the Lord. He is there to nourish you, to give you the living waters, to help you to understand what the world is coming to. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, this lockdown also is a blessing. Why do I say that? Remember in the Old Testament, Noah was given a task to save him and his family and all the earthly living creatures. He obeyed God's voice, and that willing obedience of his led to do the work what God had put it in his heart. He must have not heard the audible voice of the Lord, but he could hear, he received the voice of the Lord in his heart, in his spirit, and he acted on it. Now is the time. Each family is like an ark, building their own self. Building the ark. And who have you gathered in this ark? Whom have you gathered in this ark? Who is this whom you have brought in? Are you together? Are you praying together? Are you saying things uplifting the other person? Are you helping the other person to come out from the situation that person is facing? Is your ark complete? Many a times we have a problem answering God's voice. We all live in flats, in bungalows. Maybe have our own accommodation, a shelter place. How many doorbells do you have outside your door? How many doorbells? For a hall, one doorbell. For the kitchen, one doorbell. For the bedrooms, one doorbell. You might have a bigger doorbell for the bathroom, probably. But we know we have just one doorbell. And when you ring that doorbell, when we ring that doorbell, what happens? The ring resounds all throughout the flat, throughout the house, each and every room, every member hears that doorbell. In the same way, each member waits for the other person to answer that doorbell. The person out again, he rings the second time. One of the family members will say, please go and attend to that door. Somebody is there at the door. But yet, nobody will move. The other person has no choice, the one who is outside, he rings the third time. Somebody with a grumbling voice goes and opens the door. Are we that type of family? Are we this type of people who reside at home? The Lord is knocking. The Lord has given us this time. He has opened the hearts. He has opened our eyes. He wants you and me to respond to that knock. But we do not do that. We want somebody else to attend. And such is the time when the Lord knocks. Dear brothers and sisters, He is knocking on your door now. Open that door of yours. Open that door of your heart. Let Him come and be a permanent member of your family. God is preparing each and every individual. God is preparing each and every family. He has given us this great time that we set aside all that has been taking time away from us, the busy schedule, the things that we are caught up with. Everything has been set aside. We have been given time. But at the set time, the Lord comes. At the given time, He comes to you and to me. Are you ready to respond to His call? Is your family having the righteousness at home now? With the Lord working inside of you, with the Lord speaking to you, telling you, this is the year of preparation. Is your heart ready to repent and to forgive? Think for a moment. What is happening in this world? Where we are led? How we have drifted away from the presence and the teachings of God? Nowhere you see people are serious about upholding the word in their spirit, in their heart. Let us close the eyes for a moment. Lay aside everything. Look at that altar. Take one lamp. Even if it's a lit lamp, go to that lamp again. Blow it off, lit it again. And say, Lord, this is for the family. We are lighting this lamp. Light has entered this home. Light has entered our hearts. Light has given us the joy of dispelling darkness from within the family. Look at your spouse. Look at your husband. Look at your son and daughter and tell him you are top class. Tell him you are precious. I love you. You are top class. Let us read something over here. The word of God. James chapter 1 and verse 18. Of his own will he brought us forth by the word of truth, that we might be a kind of first fruit of his creatures. That is to be born again. That is to say that you are top class, you have been brought into the inheritance in the presence of God. You are His precious possession, and the Lord will never let go of you. Let us see something else ahead as we think of what God is doing for us and in this time of pandemic. This is the time we want to hear only good things. This is the time that we want somebody telling us about the vaccine for COVID-19. This is the time we want everybody to pray only for one petition, COVID-19. Every nation, every individual, every family concentrating only on one issue, COVID-19. How can COVID-19 come to you if you are a born again child of God, that you dwell under the shadow of the Almighty, that you are always in His presence? You have not moved out from His presence, as Psalm 91 and verse 1 says, those who dwell. So the dwelling has to be there in, with the Lord, not outside. Let us think for a moment. Have we moved out from the shadow? Have we come out from that place? And now we have a shapeless shadow moving around in this world that has caught our imagination. Every time we go, sanitize. You go to a shop, sanitize. You go to a Kanda Patata shop, he says sanitize. Sanitize, sanitize, sanitize. Even our prayers are sanitized. Why do I say our prayers are sanitized? There is nothing else coming out. Only COVID-19. Who is going to sanitize your heart? Are you not baptized? Are you not sanitized by the precious blood of Jesus? Yes. With what fear are we moving up and down? What is holding us back? What is making us fearful? Where is our faith? We say we are Catholics. We go to church. We say a rosary. We do all this. Hogwash. Sorry, I sound a bit harsh at this particular hour. But when the Spirit burns within you, He wants to speak directly into your heart so that you change and are saved. What type of world is within me? Heavenly or earthly? Do I discern? Am I ready for the change that has to be within me? Do I give everything of my old nature? And have I put on the new nature? Where God, He has a sway over the entire life of mine. Do I pull back from discipline, from correction? Do I really want God to be the center of my life? Do I trust Him? Is my faith ready to receive what He says? Because He says, without faith, it is impossible to please God. He rewards the person who walks in faith. He brings about the very joy within your heart. In faith, you draw close to God and God grows very close to you. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Because in Christ Jesus, everything is a yes for us in this life. You've got to honor Him. Think for a moment, dear brothers and sisters, in this lockdown, in this pandemic, what has happened to our families? What has happened to my way of thinking? What has happened the way I spend? What has happened? Has there a change come? What has happened with my sons and daughters? What is the bond that they are looking for? Is the bond only for materialistic things? Or is the bond becoming stronger from within, that you are really in love with this Lord of ours. This is the time for us to gain favors from the Lord, the grace that He has given us, not to throw away this time of grace what God has given us for the preparation of the things which are yet to come later on. Let us establish this great time the Lord has given us. Every moment is precious for us. Do not get discouraged. But when we throw bricks at each other, it's hurtful, it's discouraging, it's divisive, it's destructive, and such forces cannot be in the family. Do you hear the knock? Even now the Lord is knocking on someone's door. He is speaking to someone's heart. He is telling that person, change. He is telling that person, I have been knocking couple of times. I want to come there. I want to reside with you. I want to be a part of this great family. That I have come to pour out my love. God is merciful. God's love, God's mercy, hand in hand. You cannot separate these two. Even the Israelites, the people in the Old Testament, so many of these families, nations, they were destroyed. But it was always a remnant that remained. It was always God kept few behind because of His love and mercy. Even now, it is a time for us to make this drastic change in the way we think, in the way we operate, in the way the relationship we try to build with our own family members and also the people whom we come in contact with. Let us for a moment think what God is speaking to our hearts, what He wants from us. Let's open Joel. Go to the book of Joel, chapter 2 and verse 12. Let us read. Now therefore, says the Lord, turn to me with all your heart. Turn to me with all your heart. Now is the time. Now is the time the Lord, in His wisdom, in His understanding, He knows how this world is functioning. He knows every head, how they are putting up their own laws, rules, regulations to suit their own taste. They are promulgating new rules and regulations, changing constitution to suit their own interest, a few pocket, so that they can rule over the people. But God's words cannot be changed. He never changes. He is the same yesterday, today and forever. He is the everlasting one. He is the one who made the heavens and the earth. And He has framed everything in Him and through Him, that is Jesus. Are you in that frame? Are you in that frame? See what He says over here. Turn to me with all your heart. I am reading Joel chapter 2 and verse 12. With fasting, with weeping and with mourning. I am glad to announce at this time that many of you are doing this. A grieving heart inward and a weeping body which is there outside, the outward weeping, the inward grieving of your heart and the outward weeping. Lord sees both. That's what He's saying over here. So rend your hearts and not your garments. Rend your hearts and not your garments. What is your heart prepared for? What is your, are you ready to give that heart to the Lord? He does not see your outward appearance. He sees your heart. He sees your motives. He sees what you are doing and why you are doing. What you are saying and why you are saying. People will see only what you are doing, what you are saying. But the Lord will see the motive behind both of this. Think for a moment. God is not deceived. He is not mocked. Let us understand this time that He is preparing you and me. He has come to give us this moment of truth to be with Him. And imagine His arrival and you are ready. What that joy will be there. But as I said earlier, each one is preparing the ark. Can you bring some of those people whom God wants to be in this ark with you? Are you ready? Are you ready to go that one extra step? God has gone ahead of you and is saying, get them in. Most of the time we are saving the same. What do I mean by that? We want to preach to people who are already saved. Go and preach to the people who are not saved. Bring them in. Lot of opportunities are there. Lot of time is at your hand, at your disposal. And you have the word right with you. Make use of this time. Bring people closer to you. Then he says over here, return to the Lord your God, for He is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and great in kindness. He is slow to anger and He has so great kindness. It doesn't mean because He is slow to anger, is kind and is loving, that He is going to pardon sins just like that. Without you repenting or without you forgiving. No, you will have to pay the penalty of those things what you do and do not repent. But if you repent, this is what He is saying. Loving kindness of God. He is ready to forgive you instantly. To bring about His kingdom into your life. To make you aware. Let us see what He says. For He is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and of great kindness, and He relents from doing harm. Praise the Lord. Even in this time, even if you have been going and drifting away from the Lord, God is saying, still He relents from doing harm. Moses interceded. Abraham interceded. There are so many intercessory prayers that are being said. People are praying, standing in the gap, pleading. And this is what God is waiting. He is waiting for you and me to stand in the gap. Just as He destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah. But Abraham stood there. Fighting with the Lord. Interceding for them, making the point clear, Lord save, even now He is ready to save, it's never too late. Then He says here, who knows if He will turn and relent and leave a blessing behind Him. Think for a moment, in all these things, 5 months, 6 months, whatever the time limit of this COVID which has to be here on this earth with us. And then when the Lord takes it all away in His time, we'll not know. He will relent definitely because saints, sons and daughters, saints are praying all over the world. He said, I will leave a blessing for whom? For the one who has been faithful. The one who has opened his heart and welcomed Him, the family that has prepared themselves to be with you. wants to be with you. He wants that family to be saved. He wants every one of you to be saved. But from our side, we got to do our part. Let us tell the Lord in this, Lord, I've been fooling around myself for too long. I am, Lord, not worthy. But today, O Lord, I make this decision to leave aside what is not of your kingdom, to leave aside what brings about, O Lord, troubles, strife, destruction, discouragement, divisiveness, hurtful things in this time in the family, which hurts me and my near and dear ones. I make a decision, O Lord. I need your grace, I need your strength. By your Spirit, O Lord, I can move this mountain which has been plaguing me. Name that mountain. Name that mountain of yours which is there inside of you. Don't look at your husband and say, he is the mountain which has to be moved. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So a believing heart produces right behavior and good works as proof of faith. I will repeat that again. A believing heart produces right behavior and good works as proof of faith. Good works and right behavior of yours that honors God, honors Jesus. And when you do that, you know that faith has been lodged in your heart and that you are on the right track. Give yourself time today that as you listen to the word of God and as you change from within, you want new things to happen within you. You want things to come with that expectant joy to flood in you. Don't look far. Look within. Look at that light which is there already inside of you. Look at those things what you have learned and heard over these years. You have built your life, you have built your very life step by step, following what the word is telling you. Every day we fall. Every day we make mistakes. But it is the grace of God which helps you to come up and to rise up and to walk again with Him. This is the problem we have. We fall, then we get emotional, then we blame others, then we have an emotional blackmail happening within us. I am responsible, it is me, I have to destroy myself, I am not worthy to be a part of this family. That is emotional blackmail that comes from the devil. Don't listen to this liar. When you confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord of your heart, of your spirit, in your mind, your body, you make him a liar when you believe the liar, the devil. When he puts shame into you, he reminds you of the past hurts, he reminds you of the past, what you have been, what you have done, and now he knows that your focus is on the Lord. But he's a bad movie maker. He tries to rewind the old tapes. It will not work anymore in your life. Don't allow the devil to rewind the old tapes in your mind. It will not work now. You are focused on the Lord. You have started the good race. Run towards the Lord, and He will give you the grace to finish it in victory. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. All glory and praise and honor to your Lord. So as a believer, you are blessed by faith. As a believer, you are blessed by faith and you are saved by obedience. You are saved by obedience. Let us see what James chapter 5, 4 verse 5 says. James chapter 4 verse 5 says, let's open our book, our Bible, James chapter 4 and verse 5. Or do you think that the scriptures say in vain, the Spirit who dwells in us yearns jealously? Think for a moment. Or do you think that the scripture says in vain, the Spirit who dwells in us yearns jealously? When the Spirit of the Lord, the living Spirit of God, dwells in your spirit, He will just not let you go. He will not just let you be extinguished by all these difficulties, this pandemic and whatever is happening and troubling you. But He is going to fight. He is going to, how is going to fight? He is going to make you aware. He will tug at you. He will speak to you. He will encourage you. He will convict you. He will protect you. He will do everything what He has to do. Provided your final one word has to be, yes Lord. Yes Lord. I am ready for you now. He will not only guard you and protect you, but He is the one who is going to lead you into the righteous path that leads to everlasting life. The Spirit of Jesus, He yearns jealously for you. Let us look at Deuteronomy chapter 30 and verse 10. Let us see what the word of God is saying there. The Lord surrounds you and is watching over you. The Lord surrounds you and is watching over you as the apple of His eye. In minute detail, this protector and this defender whom you are confessing, He is surrounding you and He has kept His eye on you, and He has kept you as the apple of His eye. Nobody can touch you. Can the devil come near to you? Can COVID-19 come to you? They have to ask permission from the Lord. When the devil wanted to do some harm to Job, Job chapter 1 and verse 10, he had to take permission. He had to be in the presence of God. Why are you worried? Is COVID-19 troubling you? If COVID-19 is troubling you, you are not in the presence of God. And God is not watching over you. He has not surrounded you. But in Psalms 139 and verse 5, He says, I have hemmed you in front and behind on all the sides. My hand is on you. Do you have the faith to receive this word of God? Or are you going to fall backwards? Think for a moment. Think for a moment. Let us now understand during this pandemic what the Lord wants us to do. You have Deuteronomy chapter 28. 1 to 14, it says over here, the promised blessings for obedience. Promised blessings for obedience. Are you an obedient child? Willing and obedient to listen to what the Spirit of God is saying at this hour for you and your family? Then he says here, to obey diligently. That means faithful applications of one's word. You have to apply what God is saying to your day-to-day life. We have something we like to apply into other people's life because we think it is needed over there. We want to apply it into the life of my wife or my daughter, a son. Think for a moment. What are we applying? But we do not apply it to our own selves. That is what we make a mistake of ourselves. When you stand in the presence of God, God is not going to say, how many times you sanitized? How many times you applied? How many times you did this and how many times you did that for that person? You try to give bath for others when you never had bath all your life. Never had the Spirit working in you freely. Always said to him, no Lord, you got to work in my wife's life or in my husband's life or my daughter's life, but not in my life. I am self-righteous. I know what I need. I know what I am saying. Whatever is there in me, I will do. But no, listen to what God is saying today to you. Then, if you read Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 15 to 68, promise curses for disobedience. Promise curses for disobedience. We don't like to hear this type of topics. We don't want to hear this type of words. Even Jesus told those people when the cow pressed, that they thought they were sinners, that's the reason why it pressed and those people died. No, the Lord said, if you do not repent, you will also die likewise. Let us for a moment think what God is trying to tell us over here. The promise blessings of obedience and the promise curses of disobedience. Praise the Lord. Just to give you a small jhatka at this hour. Okay, let us open Deuteronomy chapter 28 and let us read verse 58. Let us read that just for you to understand what the Spirit is trying to tell you and to be careful. We are in this year of preparation. Prepare your heart. Prepare that ark. Bring all those of your family members together. Bring all the brothers and sisters in Christ to be one with you or be one with them in prayer. In prayer and in prayer. It says here, if you do not carefully observe all the words of the law, of this law that are written in this book, that you may fear this glorious and awesome name, the Lord your God. Fear of the Lord. If you do not have that, now see. Then the Lord will bring upon you and your descendants extraordinary plagues, great and prolonged plagues, and serious and prolonged sickness. Did you hear that? He says here, then the Lord, I will read it slowly, will bring upon you and your descendants extraordinary plagues, great and prolonged plagues, and serious and prolonged sickness. Moreover, he will bring back on you all the disease of Egypt of which you were afraid, and they shall cling to you. Also, every sickness and every plague which is not written in the book of this law will the Lord bring upon you until you are destroyed. Take this as a warning. When you hear the word of God, some people, they take it inwardly in so much that they feel that no, it is for destruction. No. No. 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 15 to 17 gives you the answer to what I just said earlier. Read that word. It is for our good. These warnings are for our good. This is exactly what God wants you and me to understand at this hour. Are we ready to repent? Sincerely. To forsake. To confess and to forsake. Not to sin those sins again. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Let us see why I am just saying this to you. This is how the Lord Holy Spirit just led me into the word. I know it's a bit lengthy. My this is the time that you might say okay, but this is what the Lord is telling you in Ezekiel chapter 6 and verse 9. I was cursed by the adulterous heart. I was cursed by their adulterous heart. God is crushed by our sins. Have you trusted Him? If you say you love Him, He said, you will keep my commandments. If you love me, we can confess that, yes, Jesus, I love you. But if you just confess and it does not mean anything to you, go. This is what He's saying. I was crushed by the adulterous heart. God is crushed by our sins. That's the reason why He sent His only Son, Jesus Savior. Ezekiel chapter 11 and verse 5 says, I know the things that come into your mind. I know the things that come into your mind. So He is the reader of our mind. Only He can do that. The devil does not know. He has no capacity of knowing what is happening in your and my mind. He can only influence our mind by those negative thoughts. But God is the one who reads our mind. So He knows the heart. He knows your mind. Praise the Lord. Ezekiel chapter 2 verse 20. He knows what is in the darkness. A light dwells within Him. He knows what is in that darkness. What is in that darkened soul of yours? What is that darkened place inside of you? He knows that. He knows your problems. He knows your cries. He knows the things that are troubling you. And He says, I have come to give you life. Life in all its fullness. This is the light He's talking that He says, I'm going to bring into your life today and this moment, this hour. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Glory to your name, O Lord. Let us close our eyes. Let us focus on what the Spirit of God has spoken to us. Let us keep our hands on our chest. Let us pray to the Lord. Joel says, he says carefully, multitude in the valley of decision. For the day of the Lord is near in the valley of decision. He's talking about a time of judgment. In the end times, everyone, every nation, every tongue, every tribe, every person will have to give an account of their own self. It is Yahweh, God Almighty, who is going to judge, and especially those who have rebelled against Him. Us with a humble spirit, that humble heart. Lord, here I am. Give me this joy of, O Lord, of total surrender of my life to you. The mistakes of the past, Lord, I don't want to repeat. The mistakes, O Lord, that I keep on repeating. Today, O Lord, your grace and your mercy, your love for me, and by the blood of Jesus, it has been cut off and separated from this very pandemic that is plaguing me inside my heart. I don't want to repeat, I don't want to go back. I cut myself. It is me and you, Lord, now in this hour. Lord, I want to thank you that you, O Lord, by your Spirit, given me a new heart today. Obedient and willing heart. Obey your word. Obey your voice. And what you have asked me to do, to keep all your commandments. Lord, I am privileged that you are the true living God, the Almighty, only one true living God. And as I bow down at your feet in spirit, Lord, let the cleansing waters of my baptism flow, O Lord. Cleanse me, O Lord. Make me whole. Make me new. Sanctify me, O Lord. For holiness to live a righteous life. Sanctify me, O Lord. Make me clean and holy just as you are. Lord, I give the reins of myself, my family, and all those who are connected with me into your loving hands. And Lord, I say Amen to you, the Alpha and the Omega. Oh Lord, by your word, by your spirit, and this hour has come to reside permanently in my spirit, my heart, my family, my life. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Brother Yufi, for the wonderful word of God, what we heard just now. वहां पर प्रभु हमें तैयारी करता है. प्रभु कहता है कि पश्चाताप करके वापस उनके लोगों के पास आओ. और जो लॉकडाउन के बारे में प्रभु ब्रदर ने बहुत ही अच्छी तरह से एक्सप्लेन किया, प्रभु का वचन क्या हमें कहता है. प्रभु का वचन कहता है कि आप प्रभु की और बढ़ो. जो काम प्रभु कहता है, डिट्रोनमी का बुक में हमने पढ़ा कि प्रभु हमसे प्यार करता है, प्रभु सभी को इकट्ठा करता है. प्रभु कहता है कि उनके पास नजदीक आओ. आइए एक गीत गाएंगे, उसके बाद हम ब्रदर लॉरेंस का वचन सुनेंगे. लेट अस कम एंड सिंग दिस ब्यूटीफुल सॉन्ग एंड देन वी विल लिसन टू ब्रदर लॉरेंस.
राहों में कांटे अगर हो रुकना नहीं चलते जाना.
प्रेज़ द लॉर्ड.
यीशु तेरे साथ है, ये तुम विश्वास करना.
यीशु आपके साथ, मेरे साथ, हमारे साथ हमेशा रहेंगे. ये विश्वास हम करेंगे. ये विश्वास प्रभु का है. प्रभु हमें कभी नहीं छोड़ेंगे. प्रेज़ द लॉर्ड, प्रेज़ द लॉर्ड, प्रेज़ द लॉर्ड. लेट अस सिंग टुगेदर.
कांटे अगर रुकना नहीं चलते जाना, यीशु तेरे साथ है, ये तुम विश्वास करना.
साथ में
राहों में कांटे अगर रुकना नहीं चलते जाना, यीशु तेरे साथ है, ये तुम विश्वास करना. संसार के अंत तक वो तेरे साथ है. राहों में कांटे अगर रुकना नहीं चलते जाना, यीशु तेरे साथ है, ये तुम विश्वास करना.
संसार के अंत तक,
संसार के अंत अंत तक वो तेरे साथ है। राहों में कांटे अगर हो रुकना नहीं चलते चलाना, यीशु तेरे साथ है ये तुम विश्वास करना। दुख से भरी है जिंदगी, मुसीबत भरे रास्ते हैं। दुख से भरी है जिंदगी, मुसीबत भरे रास्ते हैं। सब दूर अगर यीशु तेरे साथ है। राहों में कांटे अगर रुकना नहीं चलते जाना, यीशु तेरे साथ है ये तुम विश्वास करना। अंत तक वो तेरे साथ है। राहों में कांटे अगर हो रुकना नहीं चलते जाना, यीशु तेरे साथ है ये तुम विश्वास करना।
Praise Him. Even though you walk in the deepest water, it will not. You will not go down. अगर आप पानी में चलते हैं, पानी में भी जाते हैं, तो आपको कुछ होगा नहीं, क्योंकि प्रभु यीशु आपके साथ है. Praise the Lord.
आंधी आने दो, याने दो तूफान, आने दो याने दो तूफान, वो नैया क्या डूबेगी जिसमें यीशु महान। राहों में कांटे अगर वो रुकना नहीं चलते जाना, यीशु तेरे साथ है ये तुम विश्वास करना।
Praise Him.
अगर मौत का डर सताए तुझे सूली पर तू गौर कर, अगर मौत का डर सताए तुझे सूली पर तू गौर कर, यीशु ने मौत को जीत लिया है इस पर तू विश्वास कर। राहों में कांटे अगर हो रुकना नहीं चलते जाना, यीशु तेरे साथ है ये तुम विश्वास करना। संसार के अंत तक वो तेरे साथ है। राहों में कांटे अगर रुकना नहीं चलते जाना, यीशु तेरे साथ है ये तुम करना, ये तुम विश्वास करना, ये तुम विश्वास करना।
हालेलुया, प्रेज द लॉर्ड, लव यू लॉर्ड, adore you Lord, worship you Jesus, hallelujah, 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 praise the Lord। मेरे भाई और बहनों, ये विश्वास हमारा है कि राह में चलते वक्त भी प्रभु यीशु हमारे साथ है। मेरी जब मैं ये गाना गाते वक्त मेरी छोटी बेटी है, वो भी अपना छोटा पियानो यहाँ पे बैठकर बजा रही है। कमिया कमिया, praise the Lord, you can see her, say hallelujah, say loudly
hallelujah,
praise the Lord, say praise the Lord,
praise the Lord,
hallelujah,
hallelujah,
thank you Jesus,
thank you Jesus,
okay go, praise the Lord। मेरे प्यारे भाई और बहनों, ये माहौल आपने अपना घर पर, अब जब हम प्रेज एंड वर्शिप करते हैं तो हमारे बच्चे भी हमारे साथ जुड़ जाते हैं। What you are doing, your children will follow, praise the Lord। She enjoys, she wants to come and play and she enjoys. You have seen her for the first time. हम आपको बताना चाहते हैं, परिवार में प्रार्थना करो, प्रभु आपके साथ रहता है, आपको कभी छोड़ता नहीं है। Praise the Lord। आगे बढ़ेंगे और प्रभु यीशु का वचन सुनेंगे। अभी ब्रदर लॉरेंस हमारे लिए प्रभु यीशु का वचन देंगे, उसके बाद हम हीलिंग सर्विस करेंगे। Praise the Lord। Hallelujah। Thank you Jesus। God bless you।
Thank you Jesus। Friends, welcome to another day in Jesus. Welcome to another extract, another teaching from the Bible. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. I'm going to speak to you on the subject, be strong in faith. Aap vishwas mein ताकतवर हो जाइए। बी स्ट्रॉन्ग इन फेथ इन जीसस। नाउ द फर्स्ट स्क्रिप्चर दैट आई एम गोइंग टू टेक इज एक्ट्स ऑफ द अपोस्टल्स, प्रेरितों के नाम, चौदहवा अध्याय, 21-23 पंक्ति, एक्ट्स ऑफ द अपोस्टल्स चैप्टर 21, चैप्टर 14 वर्सेस 21-23, चैप्टर 14 वर्सेस 21-23। द सब्जेक्ट इज बी स्ट्रॉन्ग इन फेथ, यीशु के प्रति विश्वास में मजबूत हो जाइए। अपना विश्वास यीशु के प्रति मजबूत कीजिए। आफ्टर प्रोक्लेमिंग द गॉस्पल, प्रभु यीशु का सुसमाचार लोगों को बताने के बाद, इन दैट टाउन, उस नगरिया में, एंड मेनी मेकिंग मेनी डिसाइपल्स, और बहुत ही शिष्य उन्होंने बनाए, दे रिटर्न टू लिस्ट्रा एंड आइकोनियम एंड अंतियोक, और शिष्यों ने यीशु के बारे में सुसमाचार सुनाया, और लिस्त्रा, आइकोनियम एंड एंटियोक इनमें वापस आ गए। दे स्ट्रेंथन्ड द डिसाइपल्स, और उन्हें पढ़ाया, उनसे बातचीत की, और उनकी उनका जो विश्वास था यीशु के प्रति, उनका जो विश्वास था वचन के प्रति, वो उन्होंने मजबूत किया, बढ़ाया, बातें की उनसे, उनसे बातचीत की, जैसे इस समय मैं आपसे कर रहा हूं, लाइक हाउ आई एम टॉकिंग टू यू। दे स्ट्रेंथन द डिसाइपल्स, जो भी शिष्य बने थे उन गांव में, उस जगह, उनको बहुत ही सुसमाचार में ताकतवर बनाया, एंड एनकरेज देम टू रिमेन फर्म इन द फेथ, और यीशु के प्रति विश्वास ने उन्हें उनका स्वागत किया, और उनका और हौसला बढ़ाया, एनकरेज्ड, हौसला बढ़ाया। बहुत जरूरी था नवोदित शिष्य थे, दे वर न्यू डिसाइपल्स, एंड सिंस इट वॉज अ न्यू वे, द प्रीचिंग वॉज न्यू, द गुड न्यूज वॉज न्यू टू द पीपल, देर वॉज पर्सिक्यूशन, और लोग उन्हें परेशान और सताने के बहुत ही कठिन परिस्थिति थी उन लोगों की उस जगह पर, बहुत ही कठिन परिस्थिति, और इसलिए उन शिष्यों को शुभवार्ता की बात बता बता के ताकतवर बनाया जा रहा था, saying we must go through many trials to enter the kingdom of God, और परमेश्वर के राज्य में प्रवेश करने के लिए हमें बड़ी कठिनाइयों से गुजरना होगा, ऐसे उनको बताया गया, एंड यू हैव टू गो, यू मस्ट गो थ्रू मेनी ट्रायल्स, एक दो तीन चार, सिर्फ आज, सिर्फ कल, सिर्फ परसों, ऐसा नहीं, बल्कि हर दिन, हर समय विपरीत परिस्थिति, कठिन परिस्थितियों में से उन्हें गुजरना पड़ेगा, ये उनको बताया गया। इन ईच चर्च दे अपॉइंटेड एल्डर्स, एंड आफ्टर प्रेइंग एंड फास्टिंग, और हर कलीसिया में उन्होंने शिष्य और बुजुर्ग की नेमणूक की, उन्हें बताया कि ये आपके जो वरिष्ठ हैं, आपके जो बुजुर्ग हैं, वो नेतृत्व करेंगे, दे विल बी योर लीडर्स, एंड आफ्टर प्रेइंग एंड फास्टिंग, उन्होंने प्रार्थना की और उपास किया, हाँ, और दे कमेंडेड देम टू द लॉर्ड इन हुम दे पुट देयर फेथ, और उनको प्रभु के हाथ सौंपा ताकि दे परमेश्वर में उनका विश्वास बहुत ही बढ़े, और वैसी ही कुछ परिस्थिति आज भी है। देखिए, नौकरी बंद, नौकरियां चली गई हैं, सिर्फ सरकारी कामगार और सिर्फ सरकारी नौकर और अस्पतालों के कर्मचारी, पीपल हु वर्क इन हॉस्पिटल्स, पीपल हु वर्क इन गवर्नमेंट ऑफिशियल्स, पुलिस, दे आर ओनली अलाउड टू गो, अदर्स आर नॉट अलाउड टू ट्रेवल, सो दे हैव टू ट्रेवल लॉन्ग डिस्टेंसेस बाय मे बी बस, सम डिस्टेंसेस दे मे हैव टू वॉक ऑल्सो, so they are put to different tough circumstances, schools are closed, सभी छात्रों के लिए भी तकलीफ है क्योंकि सभी स्कूल बंद है, फैक्ट्री कुछ बंद है, सब फैक्ट्रीज आर लॉकडाउन, बिजनेस कम है, और कहीं कहीं तो बिजनेस है भी नहीं, धंधा भी बंद हो चुका है, कम हो चुका है, ऐसी विपरीत, क्या हमें लगता है कि परमेश्वर ने हमारा साथ बिल्कुल छोड़ दिया है? इतना मांगते हैं लोग, हमसे कहते हैं कि हम वी आर प्रेइंग अ लॉट, बट गॉड इज नॉट लिसनिंग, ऐसा हमारा परमेश्वर कतई नहीं कि वो नहीं सुनेगा, वो सुन रहा है, पर हर भक्त को इन विपरीत परिस्थितियों से गुजरना पड़ता ही है, एवरी पर्सन हु इज ऑफ द फेथ, हु बिलीव्स इन गॉड, हु ट्रस्ट्स इन गॉड, हैव टू गो एंड मस्ट गो थ्रू दीज सर्कमस्टांसेस, यू कैनॉट क्रम्बल, यू कैनॉट गिव अप योर होप, यू कैनॉट गिव अप योर करेज, आप मायूस नहीं हो सकते, आप दुखी नहीं हो सकते, आपका हौसला पीछे नहीं ले सकते, आप नीचे नहीं गिर सकते, पर आपको चलना है, चलते जाना है, क्योंकि हर बार वचन कहता है कि यदि आपको विश्वास हो प्रभु में, तो आपको थोड़ी सी कम जगह से, कम मार्ग से गुजरना होगा। आप बड़े मार्ग से गुजरेंगे तो वहां तो सभी लोग चलते हैं, ऑल द पीपल वर्क ऑन द ब्रॉड रोड, वाइड रोड, बट वी द फेथफुल मस्ट वॉक थ्रू अ नैरो रोड। इट्स नैरो बट इट लीड्स टू लाइफ। रास्ता चौड़ा नहीं है, थोड़ा सा कम रास्ता है, पर यह रास्ता अच्छाई की तरफ जाता है, प्रभु की तरफ जाता है। हमें ऐसे मार्ग से गुजरना है। देखिए योहान, जॉन, द गुड न्यूज अकॉर्डिंग टू द राइटर जॉन, शुभवार्ता योहान, तीसरा अध्याय तीसरी पंक्ति में यीशु ने निकोदेम से कहा। निकोदेम हैड कम टू हिम द नाइट एंड जीसस टोल्ड हिम, ट्रूली आई से टू यू, नो वन कैन सी द किंगडम ऑफ गॉड अनलेस ही इज बोर्न अगेन। एक बार फिर उसे जन्म लेना पड़ेगा, यानी जूना जो जीवन था वो पूरी तरह से भूल के, दैट ओल्ड लाइफ दैट वी लेड, दैट टोटली फॉरगॉट, टोटली एक्सटिंग्विश्ड, ही हैज टू बिगिन अ न्यू लाइफ, रीबॉर्न, ही हैज टू बी रीबॉर्न, नॉट इज नॉट गोइंग बैक टू द वूम एंड कमिंग बैक अगेन। नहीं, अपनी मां के कोख में जाके वापस आना ऐसा कुछ नहीं है, बल्कि ऐसा है कि एक नया जीवन, एक अनोखा जीवन, एक अच्छाई से भरा जीवन उसे जीना है। मगर हर विपरीत परिस्थिति से तो उसे गुजरना ही होगा। अब ये एक बात है, दिस इज वन कंडीशन, टू एंटर द किंगडम यू हैव टू बी रीबॉर्न, बॉर्न अगेन। दूसरा, जॉन चैप्टर 3:5, पांचवी पंक्ति, पहले मैंने तीसरी पंक्ति पढ़ी, जॉन चैप्टर 3:3 आई रेड, नाउ जॉन चैप्टर 3:5, जीसस रिप्लाइड, ट्रूली आई से टू यू, अनलेस वन इज बोर्न ऑफ वॉटर, पानी का बपतिस्मा, एंड द स्पिरिट, दैट इज द रिन्यूअल, दैट इज कमिंग ऑफ द होली स्पिरिट, रिसीविंग द होली स्पिरिट, दैट इज द लाइफ इन द स्पिरिट सेमिनार, where you go through 5 slots, Parmeshwar ka prem, the love of God, sin and its effect on human life, forgiveness of sins, new life in Jesus, a new beginning, that is baptism in the of water and spirit, one cannot enter the kingdom of God. ये दो महत्वपूर्ण बातें, these two important things. One is the old life is gone and the new has begun, born again. You are a new being in Jesus Christ. And second is, unless you, one is born of water, that is baptism, and born of the Spirit, baptism in the Spirit. It's the life in the spirit seminar where you go through and receive the gift of the spirit. Now, you cannot enter the kingdom. Now, these two things are there, but you must also realize that you have to go through the third phase, and that is to enter the kingdom, you must go through persecution. You must go through trials. आपको कठिन परिस्थितियों से गुजर के ही राज्य में प्रवेश करना है। तीसरी बात है, योहान 3 की बात अलग है। अब देखिए अय्यूब, जॉब 10:2, अय्यूब जॉन जॉब 10 जस्ट बिहाइंड साम स्तोत्र के पीछे अय्यूब 10:2 से देखिए, आई शॉल से टू गॉड डू नॉट कंडेम मी बट टेल मी व्हाट इज माय क्वारल व्हाट इज योर क्वारल विद मी। मैं परमेश्वर से कहूंगा मुझे पापी मत कहो, मेरे पाप मुझे मत दिखा, आपका मुझसे क्या झगड़ा है, मुझे बोलिए, मुझे बोलिए। अय्यूब जॉब इज टेलिंग गॉड व्हाट इज योर क्वारल विद मी, टेल मी, और इज इट योर प्लेजर जस्ट टू ऑप्रेस मी टू स्पर्न द वर्क ऑफ योर हैंड्स एंड फेवर द डिजाइन्स ऑफ द विकेट। हैव यू आईज ऑफ फ्लैश, डू यू सी अस एज मॉर्टल सी, आर योर डेज एज द डेज ऑफ मैन और योर इयर्स एज अ मॉर्टल लाइफ टाइम। Why do you see guilt in me and search for my faults? You know I have not sinned, but you can, who can rescue me from your hand? यहाँ पे, here, Job is trying to tell him that I have not done anything wrong, but yet you are sending trouble upon me. You have sent a lot of trouble about me, and people are saying that I am a sinner. He is telling God, why do you do it? Now I am going to tell you that these days, ये कठिनाइयां, ये परेशानियां, आज की परिस्थिति, it is not a trouble, ये संकट नहीं है, it is a testing of our faith, ये एक परीक्षा है, एक छात्र की जिसको विश्वास है, ये भक्त की परीक्षा है जिसे विश्वास है परमेश्वर में, बहुत विश्वास है, इट इज टेस्टिंग ऑफ आवर फेथ। और इस परीक्षा में हमें जैसे सोना गोल्ड गोस थ्रू फायर, आग से गुजरता है और सोना अपना गुण दिखाता है, वैसे हमें भी इस परिस्थिति से, इस आग से गुजरना होगा, बट बी स्ट्रॉन्ग इन फेथ, ताकतवर हो जाइए प्रभु में। इट इज नॉट दैट गॉड इज नॉट लिसनिंग, परमेश्वर सुन रहा है, परिस्थितियां धीमे धीमे बदल रही हैं, प्रभु आपके साथ है। आपके फेथ का, व्हाट इज द, आपके विश्वास का परमेश्वर के प्रति क्या ग्रेड है, क्या स्तर है, what is the grade of our faith, what exactly, क्या ग्रेड है। देखिए जॉब अय्यूब 23:10, थैंक यू जीसस। थोड़ा सा बदल देखते हैं, एक गीत लेके, Jerusalem, Jerusalem, हम उसके लिए प्रार्थना करें, खुदा का शहर जहां उसने अपने जान की कुर्बानी दी। क्या कहा मैंने, जेरूसलम जेरूसलम, हम उसके लिए प्रार्थना करें, खुदा का शहर जहां उसने अपने जान की कुर्बानी दी। मेरे लोगों तुम सुनो, यीशु की आवाज सुनो, वो आएगा तुम्हारे लिए, यीशु मसीह। थैंक यू लॉर्ड, प्रेज यू लॉर्ड, लव यू लॉर्ड, हालेलुया। जॉब 23:10, योग 23:10 क्या कहता है? बट गॉड नोज माई एवरी स्टेप, मेरा हर कदम परमेश्वर जानता है। सो आई विल कम आउट लाइक गोल्ड इन हिज टेस्ट, और जो वो मुझे परीक्षा में डाला है उस परीक्षा में मैं उत्तीर्ण दर्जे पे आऊंगा, उस आग से मैं सोना निकलूंगा, शुद्ध सोना। आई विल बी लाइक प्योर गोल्ड, आई विल कम आउट लाइक प्योर गोल्ड, दैट इज व्हाट ही सेज। नाउ माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, वी विल गो टू पॉल्स लेटर, टू सेकंड लेटर टू द कोरिंथियंस, चैप्टर 12 वर्स 10। सेकंड लेटर, पॉल्स लेटर टू द कोरिंथियंस चैप्टर 12 verse 10, Paul's second letter to the Corinthians, पौलू की दूसरी चिट्ठी कुरिंथियों के नाम, 12वां अध्याय 10वीं पंक्ति, 12:10, what does it say? So I rejoice, देखिए मैं भक्त हूं, I am faithful, I believe in Jesus, I believe in my Lord, and so I rejoice when I suffer infirmities। विभिन्न प्रकार के मारे मैं सहन करता हूं, इंसल्ट्स, लोग मेरे खिलाफ सबके सामने मुझे कुछ ना कुछ कहते हैं, मेरे खिलाफ जाते हैं, कैसे कैसे गुनाह गुनाह गुने मुझ पे लादते हैं, हर्ट मी, दे इंसल्ट मी। Yes, I rejoice when I suffer, और ये सब होते समय मैं खुश हो जाता हूं, आनंदित हो जाता हूं। I rejoice when I suffer infirmities, insults, affliction, when I am afflicted, some sickness comes upon me, when I suffer wants, जब मुझे कुछ चाहिए मिलता नहीं, जब मुझे कुछ चाहिए and I do not get, मुझे मिलता नहीं, persecutions, बहुत परेशानियां, बहुत सारी परेशानियां, कुछ है ऐसा नहीं, कभी भी कुछ कम, कभी भी कुछ नहीं, कभी नींद नहीं, कभी चैन नहीं, कभी तनख्वाह नहीं, कभी रोटी नहीं, कभी आराम नहीं, कभी विश्रांति नहीं, चिंताएं, फिर भी मैं आनंदित हो जाता हूं, क्योंकि मुझसे परमेश्वर कहते हैं मैं तुम्हारे साथ हूं, तुम एक भक्त हो, तुम्हें आनंदित होना चाहिए, यहां पे तुम्हें हर प्रकार की तकलीफ अवश्य होगी, पर उसमें भी मैं तुम्हारे साथ हूं, परमेश्वर कहता है, इसलिए मुझे। All for the sake of Christ, और ये सब मेरे इश्क के लिए, जिसने अपना प्राण मेरे लिए कुर्बान किया है, जिसने कुछ गलत नहीं किया पर सहा है। आज आम लोगों की परिस्थिति और भक्त लोगों की परिस्थिति भी उतनी ही गंभीर है, पर भक्तों में और आम लोगों में ये फर्क है। Today the situation of the common people and the people who believe in Jesus is down, depressed, low, they become nothing, but The difference between the common people and those who know Jesus is this, that even in these conditions, the faithful believe that, be strong in faith. The faithful believe that God is for them, will lift them up in these circumstances. Yes, that is the thing. That is called ये दुख, ये संकट हमारे ईमान की सच्ची परख है. ये जो दुख है, ये जो दर्द है, ये जो दिन है, ये जो हमारे पे परिस्थितियां हैं, वो हमारे ईमान की सच्ची परख है. ईमान means our belief in Jesus, our faith in Jesus. हमारे ईमान की यह परख है. This is the real, the truth. That is our identity. That in the trouble, संकट में विपरीत परिस्थिति और बहुत ही कम हमारे पास कुछ होते हुए भी हम आनंदित हैं, हम तृप्त हैं, क्योंकि परमेश्वर ने फरमाया कि मैं तुम्हारे साथ हूं, मैं तुम्हारे साथ हूं. देखिए मत्तयी 7:13-14. मत्तयी 7:13-14 किस तरह से आप भयभीत होते हैं जबकि आप तो जीवित परमेश्वर प्रभु यीशु की संतान है, जिसने हर परिस्थिति में खामोश रहे और सामना किया, परमेश्वर के आदेश का पालन किया. हम भी वही करेंगे. मत्तयी 7:13-14 Enter through the narrow gate, for wide is the gate and broad is the road that leads to destruction. जहां नाश होगा वहां रास्ता बहुत ही चौड़ा है, आराम से जा सकते हो. और सभी जाते हैं उस रास्ते से, पर कम लोग जाते हैं उस रास्ते से जो छोटा है, कम रास्ता है, कम जगह है, कम जगह है. हाँ, सच्ची, ये सत्य है, ये सत्य है. So and many go that way. How narrow is the gate and difficult the road that leads to life. Few there are who find it. बहुत कम है जो भक्त हैं और ये जो रास्ता है, छोटा रास्ता, वो अपनाएंगे. देखिए यीशु को भी क्रूस पे अकेला ही छोड़ा गया. सारे लोग एक तरफ थे उसके खिलाफ और यीशु अकेले क्रूस पे थे. आप यीशु के पीछे जाने वाले हो. You are the follower of Jesus. So, be strong in faith. Paul and Barnabas were telling the new disciples in the church in Acts chapter 14. प्रेरितों के काम में, उस किताब में पौलुस और बानाबस नए नवोदित बौतिस्मा लिए लोगों से कह रहे थे कि आप लोगों को तकलीफ अवश्य होगी और हर भक्त को तकलीफ से ही गुजरना पड़ता है. कठिन परिस्थितियों में, विपरीत परिस्थितियों में, बड़े बड़े कठिन समय से गुजरना पड़ता है यदि तुम इनाम आखिर में पाओगे. तुम्हारा इनाम बड़ा है, पर तुम्हें एक भक्त होने के नाते कठिन से कठिन परिस्थिति से गुजरना होगा. थैंक यू जीसस, प्रेज यू जीसस, लव यू जीसस, हालेलुया. Hallelujah. 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 Shalom, shalom, Jerusalem. Shalom, shalom, shalom. Shalom, shalom, Jerusalem. Shalom, shalom, shalom. Shalom, shalom, Jerusalem, tere saath shanti rahe. Jab Masih aaye, hamein le jaane ko, uski stuti tujh mein dekh sake. Jab Masih aaye, hamein le jaane ko, उसकी स्तुति तुझ में देख सके. शालोम शालोम जरूसलम तेरे साथ शांति रहे. शालोम शालोम जरूसलम तेरे साथ शांति रहे. तेरे साथ शांति रहे. जब मसीह आए हमें ले जाने को, उसकी स्तुति तुझ में देख सके. जब मसीह आए हमें ले जाने को, उसकी स्तुति तुझ में देख सके. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Brother Lawrence, for the wonderful word. Now, my dear brothers and sisters, we will move on to healing prayer. Healing service and final service of this healing sessions. Let us come together to the Lord and put ourselves into the hands of Jesus. हम अपने आप को लेकर प्रभु यीशु के सामने हमारे हम रख देंगे. लेट अस सरेंडर आवरसेल्व्स इनटू द हैंड्स ऑफ जीसस और प्रार्थना करेंगे, ये प्रभु आप हमारे लिए युद्ध करना, हमारे लिए लड़ाई करना. प्रभु हम अपने आप को एक मड़की के जैसा कुंड को लेकर आपके सामने आते हैं और उसे बराबर करना प्रभु, और उसे अपना शक्ति और सामर्थ्य से भर देना. हम गाएंगे, प्रभु की आराधना करेंगे. सभी लोग एकजुट होकर प्रभु की आराधना करेंगे. लेट अस कम एंड वर्शिप जीसस. मेरे छोटे हृदय से मेरे महान प्रभु की आराधना करूं. टूटे हुए कुंड को मेरे कुंभार के पास लाकर ठीक करने की विनती करूं. मेरे छोटे हृदय से मेरे महान प्रभु की आराधना करूं. कुंड को मेरे कुंभार के पास लाकर ठीक करने की विनती करो. होसाना होसाना यहूदियों के राजा को गाएंगे. होसाना होसाना आने वाले राजा को. साथ में अपना हाथों को उठा कर होसाना होसाना यहूदियों के राजा को. होसाना होसाना आने वाले राजा को. surrender yourself into His hand. अपने जीवन प्रभु यीशु के हाथ में सौंप कर आराधना करो. Surrender your life in His hand.
मिट्टी से बनाया गया हूं, फिर मिट्टी में जा मिलूं.
Beautiful words.
मिट्टी से बनाया गया हूं, फिर मिट्टी में जा मिलूं. मुझ मिट्टी को महिमा में बदलने, तेरे महिमा को त्याग दिया. मुझ मिट्टी को महिमा में बदलने, तेरे महिमा को त्याग दिया. ओ सना, ओ सना, यहूदियों के राजा को
बोशे.
ओ जाना, ओ जाना, आने वाले राजा को
साथ में.
ओ जाना, ओ जाना, यहूदियों के राजा को. ओ जाना, ओ जागो.
ये प्रभु जब हमारे जीवन में कदम लड़खड़ाते हैं तो प्रभु हमें कृपा देना आ संभाल कर आगे बढ़ना. हम विनती करते हैं प्रभु, वी प्रे लॉर्ड, और हमारे कदम सिद्ध करने प्रभु तेरा सेवा में हम कृपा से आगे चल पड़े. ये प्रभु हमें मदद करना.
Jesus, kadam ladkaadte samay mein, tere kripa sambhala mujhe. Kadam ladkaadte samay mein, tere kripa sambhala mujhe. मेरे कदम सिद्ध करने तेरे सेवा में, कृपा से चलाया मुझे. मेरे कदम सिद्ध करने तेरे सेवा में, कृपा से चलाया मुझे. ओ साना, ओ साना, यहूदियों के राजा को. ओ सन्ना, ओ सन्ना, आने वाले राजा को. ओ सन्ना, ओ सन्ना, यहूदियों के राजा को. ओ सन्ना, आने वाले राजा को.
Jesus. We surrender. Every brothers and sisters at your feet, O Lord Jesus. You can do wonders, Lord, in everyone's life. We believe and we trust in you. Take away every fear from everyone's heart, O Lord. Fear of this sickness, Lord. Lord, we pray, take away every fear from their hearts and minds. Hey, Prabhu, hum vishwas karte hain aapke upar. Har ek dar insaan se aap nikal do, Prabhu. Aur unhe shakti aur samarth se bhar do. Us dar ko nash karo, Prabhu. O rakhiya ra 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 ra. Is sansar ki yatra mein mere jeevan ka ek sapna hai. इस संसार की यात्रा में मेरे जीवन का एक सपना है. मेरे अंतिम श्वास जाने तक तेरा नाम को प्रकाशित करूं. मेरा अंतिम श्वास जाने तक तेरा नाम को प्रकाशित करो. Yes, Lord. Till my breath, Lord, give us that grace to proclaim your word to the ends of the earth. Give that grace to every brothers and sisters, O Lord. We pray. Yes, Lord.
मेरे छोटे हृदय से मेरे महान प्रभु की आराधना करूं.
वर्षिपिंग.
टूटे हुए कुंड को मेरे कुंभार के पास लाकर ठीक करने की विनती करूं.
और एक बार.
मेरे छोटे हृदय से मेरे महान प्रभु की आराधना करूं. टूटे हुए कुंड को मेरे कुंभार के पास लाकर ठीक करने की विनती करूं.
आतोटा का
ओ जन्ना यहूदियों के राजा को. ओ आने वाले राजा को. ओ सना यहूदियों के राजा को. ओ सना आने वाले राजा को.
Lord Jesus, we pray, Lord, we surrender, O Lord. O Lord, have mercy and compassion upon your brothers and sisters. O Rakhi,
hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Surrender and pray. Surrender and pray. He is healing you, he is touching you. Oh Jesus, we worship you. We glorify your name. We believe in your power and mercy, Lord Jesus. I have compassion upon your brothers and sisters, Lord. Oh Rakia. Oh Jesus. He's healing you. Many are going to be touched right now as you're adoring and worshipping. Prabhu ne bahut jan ko chua hai. Prabhu ne bahut jan ko chua hai. Those who are having the sleep disc problem, the Lord has healed you. Just get your healing. Get your healing. Receive your healing. Depression, the Lord has taken away. The fear is taken away from your hearts and mind. Just worship. Just worship.
I am the Lord who elected Jesus. I am the Lord your healer.
This Jesus says to each one of us,
I sent my word and healed your disease. I am the Lord your healer.
Believe in Jesus. Turn to Jesus. Come back to Jesus. He is healing you. He is delivering you. He is pouring out His power upon you. Jesus, we trust in your Lord. We trust in your mercy. Oh, Rakia, da, 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 da. Oh Jesus, surrender my dear. Surrender and pray. There is mighty anointing is flowing upon you and your family and your brothers and sisters. Oh, Rakia, da, 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 da. Jesus,
you are the Lord who led thee.
Yes, Lord.
You are the Lord my healer. You send your word and healed my disease.
He's healing you.
You are the Lord my healer.
Just surrender. Just surrender. Just surrender the Lord's power. Lord's power. Lord's power. Lord's power is healing you. Lord's power is healing you. Oh Lord, we surrender and pray.
The
Lord is telling you, even if the world leaves you, even the entire world is going to leave you, but I will never leave you. I will never leave you.
Oh, samsar tu ka sandi tari.
Jesus says to you,
how san sona tu ka harmonies tu ka anat kari tari anat tu nai ma ka.
Jesus telling you, my dear,
oh samsar tu ka Sanitari.
He's telling you, he's telling me,
how san so na tu ka harmonies tu ka anat kari tari anat tu nai ma ka.
Oh Lord, को बंद कर अपने मन की इच्छाएं पवित्र सैक्रामेंट के सामने रख दीजिए. प्रे एंड सरेंडर योर पिटीशंस इंटेंशन बिफोर द जीसस थ्रू दिस ब्लेस्ड सैक्रामेंट. लेट अस प्रे फॉर आवर पर्सनल लीड. हम अपने आप को प्रभु यीशु के हाथ में सौंप देते हैं. इस पवित्र सैक्रामेंट के सामने अपने हर एक इच्छा हर एक मनोकामनाएं प्रभु के सामने रख दीजिए. प्लीज प्रे फॉर ए पर्सनल इंटेंशन. Close your eyes and pray. All your needs the Lord is going to fulfill. All your needs the Lord is going to give it to you. Just close your eyes. अपने आंखों को बंद करके प्रभु के ऊपर ध्यान करके अपने हर एक इच्छाएं प्रभु के सामने रख दीजिए. I am telling you, whatever you pray today in the name of Jesus, it is given to you right now. Right now, the Lord is going to bless you. Lord is going to pour out His power upon you. He will prosper you. He will make you the worthy nations. He will be with you all the time. Through the ends of the earth, the Lord promised that I will be there for you. I am there for you. Just close your eyes and pray. Close your eyes and pray for your personal intention. Pray. Surrender and pray. Types of ailments the Lord is showing me. The ailment of the heart, ailment of the diabetes, ailment of the stomach, knee problem, problems in your body, body ache, not getting sleep, headache, migraine, heart problems, cholesterol problems, pressure problems. The Lord has delivered and healed you. There is no need of mentioning much more. The Lord is healing you. You can experience His touch and heal. Thank you, Lord. Just thank the Lord. Just thank the Lord who is in the blessed sacrament. Thank you, Jesus. Just thank Him. Thank you, Jesus, for all the blessing and healing. Thank you, Jesus. Just say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Awesome power. Awesome grace, my dear brothers and sisters. Who can love us so much? Not even our own person can love, that Jesus loves you and me. Never leave Jesus. Never lose His anointing and touch. Even though whatever may happen in your life, Jesus will never leave you. Even during the time of our last death, last breath, He will send His angels to take you to heaven. This is a promise of God. Just thank the Lord. Let us bow our head. As we are concluding this session, thank the sacrament, thank this Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament, and we thank you.
Oh, come let us adore Him.
Thank Him.
Oh, come let us adore Him. Oh, come let us adore Him. Christ the Lord, Param Prasad He, Prabhu Ka Sharir He. करते हम सदा आराधना, करते हम सदा आराधना।
हाथों को उठाकर अपने सर को झुकाकर नमन करेंगे।
आराधना आराधना आराधना
every one of you for your support, so that we can reach out to others. I'm telling you, the Lord has done so much of miracles in everybody's life. There are so many calls, the people calling up, sending the message, brother done like this, God has done like this. After watching praise and worship, it is not my wish, it is Jesus wish, and the one who is healing is Jesus, not any human being. Let us give glory to Jesus, because all glory belongs to Jesus. And thank you for your help. Thank you for your support, so that we can reach out others. I want to tell you, testify you, there are so many poor people who always come and ask. There are so many who are living in the rented house, doesn't have money to pay for the rent. We have been reaching, myself and our father and in our ashram, we are reaching so many people. Sometimes people give some things and we just utilize for their benefit and their help, and God is helping us. It is our nature to help each other. Thank you, my dear. Continue to support us. Continue to render your hand to us, so that whatever the Lord has given the mission, it's not only preaching, it is not only praising, not only conducting the praise and worship, but the Lord has given the mission to reach out others. Our ministry doesn't have any account, any fund, nothing. Whatever the Lord blesses, we reach out to others. Reach out to others. That is a blessing for God. And we will continue till our last breath. We will do that. Giving to others. Give yourself to others. And Lord will bless you. Thank you, my dear brothers and sisters. Please do share this healing service. We try to add the word of God. Even though those word of Gods are recorded in their own houses, these my brothers are taken pain, taken effort, taken lots of pain in preparing the word of God and giving and putting for the healing service. Thank you, my dear brother Lawrence and brother Yufi. And thank you, all of you, my dear brothers and sisters. So we try to put the word of God for this healing service. We try to continue the word of God during our Fridays. Let's pray. Let's pray to the Holy Spirit. Lord, may give the wisdom and knowledge and let us continue. And Lord is always there for us. Amen. Amen. Do share this word present. Even though it is long, I know that during the word of God, they are inspired by the Holy Spirit. That's why they speak little longer. Even our session also is inspired by the Holy Spirit. We cannot cut short. It goes long. But still, you can take this time of the lockdown. You are in the house. Listen to the word. Pray with Jesus. And God is going to bless you. Thank you. God bless you. God is good all the time. And all the time, God is good. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Can we say that again? For the kingdom, the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. God bless you, my dear brothers and sisters. We are all praying for you. Do keep us in your prayers. Do keep our ministry in your prayer. Do keep our father in the ashram and all our team members and all our brothers in your prayer so that Holy Spirit may work through each one of us. First and foremost, pray that we should be humble. When you are humble, Lord will lift you up. The pride should not take over anyone. Do not work for the fame and name, but with the humble heart, serve the Lord. Lord is going to bless you and me. Thank you. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you.